Hello everyone, again I'm going to show you how to grow crystals and make a silicon druzy coaster mold and a smaller geode shaped inlay mold. In this video I will show the whole process of growing the crystals, making the silicon molds and pouring the resin coasters. So for the new people to my channel that like tutorials of resin and silicon mold making, consider to subscribe. I have a lot of other tutorials about acrylics, mixed media, alcohol ink and a lot more. And if you subscribe to my channel, then don't forget to click the notification bell and select all, because that way you don't miss any future videos that I will be uploading to my channel. Yeah, again, I'm going to make some druzy silicon molds, and I already started with it. The black base is made out of polymer clay, and I'm using it from the brand Fimo Soft. And this polymer clay you need to bake in an oven for about 30 minutes on a temperature of 110 degrees, and then it's baked. And then you can use it as a base to grow your crystals on. So I made a round shape. It's about 1 centimeter thick. And I already added some wood glue. And I'm using the brand Patex. I don't think you can buy this in the USA or outside of Europe. But you need a water-resistant wood glue, because you place your base in a mixture of water and alum salt. So that's why you need a water resistant wood glue. And on top I'm adding the alum crystals or alum salt. And I get a lot of questions which brand I'm using and how the alum looks. So it's not a powder. It's more like a grain of salt, the normal salt you use. So it's not a powder, but I already got some feedback from people that they use the powder, the alum powder, and that it also works. So I don't know, because I never used it before. I'm always using the alum salt, but if you have the powder, then you need to try it out. So this is this will be a smaller geode-shaped inlay mold, and it can be used inside of a coaster mold, so that you can make a hole in the middle. So this is also made out of the polymer clay, and added the wood glue, and now I'm going to add the alum salt again. Yeah, and this needs to dry for at least 24 hours before I can add the mixture, because the wood glue needs to be totally dry. Otherwise, your crystals will not grow and they come loose from your black base. So we are 24 hours later and the wood glue is dry, so I'm going to add the first mixture, and I've boiled 600 milliliters of water and it's really hot. And now I'm going to add 150 gram of alum salt. And yeah, the rule is that you need to add that much alum salt that it doesn't dissolve in your water anymore. So if it's more than 150 gram, it's also okay. But I measured it, and it's about 50 gram on 200 milliliters. So I have 600 milliliters, so I need to add at least 150 gram of alum salt. I placed my shapes in a plastic container on the left side, you can see it there, and I'm going to add the mixture in the plastic container, and I'm going to add that much that the shapes are about 1 centimeter below the water. But I can still add some alum salt, so that's why I'm mixing still. So I don't wait until the mixture is cooled off. I boil it and I pour it straight away in my plastic bucket. And then I add the alum salt so that it can dissolve in the hot water. So there's enough of the alum salt in the water. And now I need to strain it, because if there are still some pieces of salt in the mixture, you don't want that, because that can affect your crystal that you are going to grow. So it needs to be strained. There you can see it. Another container. Straining it through a paper towel. Or a paper napkin. And now I'm going to add the mixture into the plastic container. There you can see it. Until the shapes are totally below the water. About 1 centimeter below it. And then I leave it for 24 hours at least. And you need to close it off, not totally, because then still need to come air into the plastic container. Again, we are 24 hours later. I'm going to take my shapes out of the plastic container. There you can see it. And I have a lot of crystals. Really nice. And I think after one mixture, it's already done. I can let it dry and make some silicon molds out of it. But first, I need to clean them a little bit or dry them with a paper towel. I'm going to keep that water, because you can use it again if you boil it again and you check if you can add more alum salt, then you can use that mixture again. So a closer look. Going to dry them a little bit with a paper towel. Then I check the back, because I need a flat bottom. So I'm taking away pieces of the crystals, because the bottom needs to be flat before I can make a silicon mold out of it. Also need to clean the geode shape, cleaning the bottom or the backside. Yeah, I'm not sure which word I need to say for that. So this should dry at least 24 hours, maybe more, until you can add some clear gloss varnish on top of the crystals, because you need to spray it, otherwise your crystals will break off. Closer look, very nice. So I'm already at the start of making the silicon mold. So I want to explain what I did. the coaster mold on the right side, I'm using a plastic flower tray, and my tray was way too large, so that's why I've added the yellow soft molding dough, and it's from the brand Pelican. I will try to add a link in the description box below this video, because I don't want to waste that much silicone, so that's why I've added the soft molding dough. And I already know that the silicone will not stick to the soft molding dough. And on the left side, the geode shape inlay mold, also some soft molding dough underneath, so to prevent that it will not leak. And to fill these molds, I've used about 400 gram of silicone rubber, and I'm using a black silicone rubber. You can make it any color you want, because there are colorants to color your silicone rubber. And the one on the right, the coaster mold, I let it overflow a little bit. So this will dry for at least 24 hours. So we are 24 hours later. I'm starting on the smaller geode shape mold to take it out of the base mold. There you can see it. Very carefully. And it's looking okay. Now I'm starting on the coaster mold. What I already mentioned, I let it overflow, because then I know for sure that I have added enough silicone rubber. And what you already can see is that the crystals have broke off. So I didn't add enough of the gloss varnish, but that's no problem. It's also an experiment, and I can fix it. There you can see it. My base is still in the silicone mold, and you can see all the crystals lying in my mold, but that's no problem. I can remove them and clean it. So I cleaned the silicone molds, I removed all the crystals, I also cut the edge, and now it looks nice. Nice enough to pour some resin in it. But before I'm going to do that, I'm using again one of my newer items that I will be adding soon to my Etsy shop. And this is a chameleon pigment pen, and this color shifts from red to magenta and green. So at the end of this video, I will show you all a close-up, and then you can see it much better. But on the edge, I'm going to add this nice chameleon color with the pen. And this is an amazing pen. No more flying around of mica pigments. In the lid, there is chameleon pigment. And on the tip of the pen, there is a sponge. And if you twist the sponge in the lid, then you pick up the chameleon pigment, and then you can add it where you want to. So I'm using it now in a silicone mold, but you can also use it on top of resin. In later videos, I will show you that. But for now, I'm going to add it on the edge. So also an experiment. I never done this before, but it already looks amazing. And you don't need a lot of this pigment. So I'm adding only a little bit on the tip of the sponge. And then you can apply it in your silicone mold. But you don't need a lot of this pigment. And I'm happy with that, because you all know if chameleon pigments are very expensive. So I'm very pleased that you don't have to use a lot of this pigment. So I may also made a second coaster mold, Drusy coaster mold. So I'm going to make two, resin coasters. And it already sparkles a lot. So hopefully my coasters will also sparkle this much. But you can see it's so easy to apply that pigment in your silicon mold. Yeah, and I hope to get these listed in my Etsy shop this month. And first I will get 6 colors of the chameleon pigment. And they will also be available for the people that live in the USA and Canada. The rest of the world can buy them in my Etsy shop. But my associate Evelyn will also have them available in her Etsy shop. So that's great. And so first 6 colors, and after that I will also get 3 iridescent gold colors and 1 iridescent silver color. So I'm very pleased. So I'm going to pour some resin, and I'm starting with some black, not too much, only on the edge, and I'm using the Resi-Tint black ink. I'm only going to use 3 colors. This is a Bombay ink in the color red. And again, the Resi-Tint black on the edge. And in the middle, a Bombay ink in the color magenta. So if I pour all the way up to the top, then the coasters will be about 13 millimeters thick. So that's great. So I'm not going to pour all the way to the top, so that my coasters will be 1 centimeter thick. So these coasters will have some black and 2 colors, 2 shades, 1 red and 1 magenta. And of course on the edge, the chameleon color that shifts from red to magenta and also green. So I'm very curious how this will look. Some clear in the middle. And the resin I'm using is the Art Pro resin. And I think it's an amazing resin. I can pour up to 1 centimeter, so that's great. Not a lot of air bubbles. And if you are interested in the supplies of Resin Pro, I have a promo code for their website. If you use my code Petra, then you get 10% discount on your total value order. And my promo code is available for all their websites. So all the information to that is in the description box below this video. So I'm almost done. Need to let this dry for at least 24 hours and then I can take them out of the mold. So we are 24 hours later. Now I'm going to take them out of the mold. I'm very curious how they will look, if the chameleon pigment looks nice. And what I also need to mention, the smaller geode shape inlay mold I will be using in another video, in a coaster mold. So the first one is already out. Now the second one, you can already see the nice shades of red, also black and magenta. They are transparent, so that's good. And there you can see the chameleon pigment. You can already see the magenta color. But it also shifts to red and green. And the second one, also that very nice. And it sparkles a lot. So I'm so pleased at how they turned out. I only need to work on the silicon coaster molds. Closer look. There you can see it. Very nice. And the other one. This is more magenta color. Yeah, I'm very happy with the outcome. So this is the end result. I have them outside in the daylight. Hopefully you can see all the color shift colors, the chameleon colors. It shifts from red to magenta and green. I think you can see it. The green, very nice. And it sparkles a lot. So the next time I will be using other colors, not a red or a magenta. But you can see the chameleon colors very well. Also there. The nice green, yellow green. So I hope to list these chameleon pens very soon in my Etsy shop. And let me know what you think of my Druzy coasters and chameleon pen. I would really like to know it. All the information to the supplies I've used you can find in the description box below this video. And don't forget to give me a thumbs up for this video if you like what I'm doing. Also the link to my Etsy shop and the Etsy shop of my associate Evelyn Schaefer in the USA you can find in the description box. I want to thank you all for watching again and hopefully I will see you all in the next video. Bye!